fine 80s and 90s pop music, but her new memoir, Lips Unsealed, exposes the drugs, booze, and dark side of rock and roll. Please welcome Belinda Carlisle.
My in high school, we did that to our talent show, Our Lips Are Sealed. We did your song.
That's so sweet.
How did the song come about? Like, a little background on it, because it's such a huge hit.
Well, I mean, we started from nothing. We didn't know how to plug our guitars into amplifiers. So Jane numbered her guitar from, like, 1 through 12. Okay. And it was a letter from the band we were opening for. I'm not going to say who was having a thing with who. Uh-huh. But it was a letter, and Jane wrote the music like 6, 2, 4, 3, and so on. And that's how that song came out.
Uh-huh. Wow. Can I ask you a hot topic that we were discussing? Because I was reading that you and your husband moved to the south of France at one point, and you were friendly with Duchess of York,
right.
Sarah Ferguson. What was your personal impression of her?
Oh, I thought she was great. And it was a long time ago. I haven't talked to her in a long time. She seemed like she needed a friend, actually.
She needed a friend.
Yeah, and we had a really nice time, and I liked her a lot, and I could not watch that tape.
So. You couldn't watch it?
No. Mm-mm. No.
Why?
It made me uncomfortable, and obviously something's going on. Who knows what, but something.
Right, absolutely.
So. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
George, wow. Just mentioned Morgan. 25 years you've been married?
Yeah. 25 years, yeah.
Yeah, and you know, in the book, you talk a lot about how you went through addiction and were trying to hide the addiction from him.
Right.
And do you think without him you would be clean? And how do you even go about hiding it from
him? Well, I think that he, you know, I mean, I struggled for 30 years, you know, with drugs and alcohol, and it's only 5 years of sobriety now. And I think after a certain point,
yeah.
That's about time,
I
mean, better late than never. So I think,
did you think you were hiding it from him, or were you really hiding it from him?
How did you hide it? And how many times did he bust you, too? That's what I want.
You know something? I mean, the sickness of addiction is that, yeah, he did bust me sometimes. And I live in the south of France. I've been there for a long time, and I purposely never had a connection there, because mm-hmm. I traveled a lot in my work, and I had my connections everywhere else. So the times he did catch me, of course I made the promises never to do it again. Mm-hmm. And you mean them from the bottom of your heart, but you can't keep them.
You know, in your book, you're very, very honest about your addictions mm-hmm. with alcohol. It was primarily cocaine.
Right.
You said that even when your son was 5 years old, you did drugs in the school bathroom.
Well, that's how sick I was.
And I would think as a mom, that would be a rock bottom point. Was
well,
that for you?
Everybody's not bottom is different.
An addict and a mom are two separate things.
Right, explain
it. It's pretty bad. Yeah. I mean, that's a bottom. I mean, everybody's bottom is different. That wasn't a bottom, obviously. It should have been. My bottom was more of a spiritual bottom, mm-hmm. I think. And ultimately, it was a choice between life and death. So, but I think, you know, I don't have any regrets about my addiction, and I have an amazing life. I do have one regret, and that I was not as present as I should have been as a mother. Mm-hmm. And I'd like to think that I've made up for that in the past 5 years, you know?
You were married for 25 years. And do you feel your husband's love is very unconditional? Because
oh,
to
yeah.
go through this
it would
with
have
you?
To be. I mean, would have
he's
to
like
be.
A solid guy.
My husband
guy
is a saint. He should be sainted, actually.
Yeah. This is amazing that he remained through this. And,
my
and
husband's a very, like, he should be sainted.
Yeah.
What can I say?
Well, you know this, though. You don't take
yeah.
it for granted.
I mean, I'm
you
very
know.
Lucky. He's, you know, he was there. He's been there for me, although he had to let go after a certain point and say, you know, whatever, because mm-hmm. what can you do? You know, I mean, he saw the person that underneath all the stuff, so.
When you were pregnant, you didn't do cocaine
no.
when you were pregnant. You had stopped, but you drank every
yeah.
day that you were pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
So you were able to keep that from your husband as well?
Yep. I was, and I didn't drink a lot, but still, I mean, you sort of wonder when your child is born and weighs 3 pounds, that maybe, could that have had
yeah.
any sort of
yeah.
impact on it? What can we all do the best we can, you know, and I did the best I could considering the circumstances, and there's not a lot I would change. The mother, the stuff regarding
mother.
Me being a mother, I would change
that. Your son came out at 15 years old?
Yeah.
That's pretty self-aware, I would say.
Well, I've had little hints along the way, so it wasn't like
you
a
mean
big
when he dressed up as Cinderella and would lose his slipper like I would? The bell's ringing! I would do it.
Little indication. So it wasn't, I mean, most of my friends are gay and lesbians, mm-hmm. you know, 90% of them, actually, so.
But I'll when call
it's
you
your,
later.
But when, okay. but when it's your own son, you know, I mean, I was still pretty shocked. And he said, I have something to say to you. And when he told me, I had to pull the car over. Mm-hmm. And then I was like, oh, my God, what am I going to tell my husband? You know, what am I going to do? And that took about 3 months because I didn't know.
Your husband?
Well, I didn't know.
Yeah.
You know.
How did the saint take it?
Well, I waited until he took a shower one morning. And I sat down. I said, I have to tell you something. And he goes, yep. And I said, Dickie likes boys. And he went, no, come on. And it was like, actually, it took him a good year.
Really?
To deal with it?
Yeah, he had to process it. I mean, for some men, it's a reflection on their masculinity, I think. And
but did he remove him? Did you feel he removed himself from your son?
Well,
at all,
you know, something. I let those two go at it. I said, I'm not in the middle of it. I did my job.
You had other stuff going on. Let me ask you, how did you start?
How did I start?
Yeah, how did you start?
Well, I started back in the punk days, the punk days in Los Angeles in 1977, when everybody I knew in the punk scene, 50 people, everybody was in a band and they were horrible. So it's like, you could be in a band and be horrible, too, and be cool. And in fact, knowing how to play an instrument was almost like not cool. It wasn't done. So we were sitting on a curb one night, and it was like, I'll play bass, I'll play drums. And I had played drums in a band called The Germs, so I didn't want to play the drums. So I thought, okay, I'll sing. And that's how the band started. And, you know, it's an American dream. And it's within 2 years, 2.5 years of forming ourselves and not knowing how to do anything, and then becoming the biggest thing in America, you kind of think, you know, it's a little bit meant to be,
but
I think.
And it's fun because,
I'm sorry.
No, go ahead.
I'm new here.
Proceed, Mario.
You still didn't feel worthy of it, though, when you had number one hits. I mean, you didn't feel, you felt like you were a fake?
Yeah, I mean, that goes way back to, like, things that I didn't realize at the time that were big issues, like father issues, mm-hmm. father figure issues. I had a lot of daddy damage, and I think, a lot of abuse issues, a lot of emotional abuse issues that you carry with you. And actually, the stuff that you sort of causes that hole in the soul, that you do all that stuff in eating and, you know,
trying to fill that
hole.
Sure.
And that hole came from, I think, from a lot of my childhood. And
you're so open in this book, and I truly think women can relate to so much of your story in one aspect or another. I want to let everybody know, too, you're going to be at Lilith coming up. And also, everyone in our audience, by the way, is taking a home copy of the Lilith book. Thank you so much.